So one of my favorite stations growing up as a kid was Cartoon Network. And over the years, Cartoon Network has changed a lot, sometimes for the better, sometimes for the worse. There were like really good shows that they had on Cartoon Network, bad shows on Cartoon Network. And basically, in this rant, I'm just going to talk about Cartoon Network, obviously, because that's what I'm talking about right now. But I'm just going to talk about basically growing up with Cartoon Network, my favorite shows on Cartoon Network, where I think Cartoon Network stands as of this point as a TV station and stuff like that. Basically, I'm just going to talk about Cartoon Network and just go on a complete rant. I have a list of notes right here, but I don't know if I'm going to actually follow this, but if I do, then props up to me. But let me know what you guys think about Cartoon Network down in the comment section below. Let me know if you watched Cartoon Network in the past and if you think Cartoon Network is good as it is right now, if it was better back in the day. I'm definitely going to give my opinion on that like towards the end of the video, but yeah, let's go ahead and just jump into this rant though, right? Right. So I grew up with a lot of Cartoon Network when I was younger. When we finally got cable, I was around maybe 7 or 8 years old, and I don't know, I just found Cartoon Network. It was channel 69, I think. 69, that's funny, right? I know. But it was channel 69, and my TV never left that channel. Basically, I didn't even know what Nickelodeon was because Cartoon Network was so good. It had so many great shows on it. It had Whatever Happened to Robot Jones, Ed, Edd n Eddy, Powerpuff Girls, Cow and Chicken, Johnny Bravo, Dexter's Laboratory, Grim and Evil, and it had like all the Boomerang shows like Flintstones, Smurfs, and just like Jetsons, all these good shows. And I really enjoyed those shows so much to where I never changed my TV ever. Like, Cartoon Network primetime was so amazing because at night you'll have things like Kids Next Door, you'll have you'll just have all like Kids Next Door, you'll have like Billy and Mandy, and then you just have all these other shows and stuff. And then Adult Swim would start at like 11 o'clock, and then Adult Swim had Futurama, Family Guy, and then just like a whole bunch of random shows. And it had like anime. They play anime every single day, even though it was like for 1 hour. They play anime every single day. Most likely, most of the time it was like Inuyasha and Bleach or something. And I don't know, I just really, really enjoyed Cartoon Network back in the day. Now, as of today, today's Cartoon Network, I honestly don't enjoy it as much as the old Cartoon Network, just because like the phases that Cartoon Network has been through. I can't stand the phases that Cartoon Network has been through, to be honest with you. I did like the some of the newer shows that they added. They added like Teen Titans, they added like Justice League, Young Justice, all that stuff. They had Hi-Hi Puffy AmiYumi, they had Juniper Lee, they had all these shows, Robot Boy, you know, they had all those shows. I like those shows, I enjoyed those. But then Cartoon Network went through that weird phase. Let's talk about the phase of Cartoon Network though. But the phase that they went through though, with that whole it started with that movie that dealt with that kid Jimmy, I think, where he got this like cartoon dude's brain, and then he started seeing cartoons and could talk to cartoons. And that is probably the point where Cartoon Network went all downhill for me. That's when Cartoon Network literally became complete and utter ass to me, because from there they started showing real people on Cartoon Network, and it's like you can't have a network called Cartoon Network and then you have real people on Cartoon Network. I just felt that itself was just a contradicting, because it used to be all about the cartoons. The cartoons would run the network, you know. They had Cartoon Fridays that was ran by the cartoons themselves, and I really, really enjoyed that. I enjoyed that so much, you know, like I really enjoyed that so much. And then everything just went downhill. They started doing this like Fried Dynamite shit on Fridays and Saturdays or something, or they took Cartoon Fridays away and they started doing Fried Dynamites on like Saturday morning. And I was like, what the fuck is this? This is so stupid. And it was like these kids and stuff, and I'm just like, I don't understand what this is. This doesn't make any sense whatsoever. And by this time I was like entering high school or something like that, or I was in the middle of high school, and I was like, this is stupid. So that's when I actually started journeying out and venturing out to other networks like Disney and Nickelodeon and stuff like that. But I don't know. I felt that that itself was just so fucking stupid. But then Cartoon Network went through that phase of seeing real, where basically they just had like all these real people on Cartoon Network. And that was stupid. That was so fucking stupid. In my personal opinion, I mean, that was probably the dumbest thing that they've ever done, ever. Because it's like, you can't call it, because like CN Real translates to Cartoon Network Real. Like, that doesn't make any sense to me whatsoever. That's like contradicting itself. That's just a contradicting name. It's like Cartoon Network, and then you have real people. That didn't make any sense to me whatsoever. So when that was a thing, they had, what was it? There was Out of Jimmy's Head. There was Destroy, Build, Destroy. There was Dude, What Would Happen? Oh my gosh. Dude, What Would Happen was literally one of the worst possible fucking shows they've ever made. I'm so sorry. I couldn't stand that show. It was so stupid. Like, dude, what would happen if we took a giant container of lemonade and put it on the front of the car? What the hell do you think you're gonna, what do you think is gonna happen? You're gonna have a giant container attached to a fucking car, and you can drink from the lemonade if you have a giant straw that goes through the fucking window. What do you think is gonna happen? Like, dude, what would happen if we did this? Dude, what would happen if I took my freaking keyboard and snapped it in half? Dude, what do you think is gonna happen? Like, that show was literally just so stupid. I never understood why that was even a thing. Like, that was stupid. That was so dumb. I hated that. I hated that so much. They had, what was it? Hole in the Wall? Like, Hole in the Wall. That made no sense to me either, because it was like, you have these people in these shiny tight suits. Doesn't even look good on them. And you have them trying to fit through a tiny, so you have a person like this trying to fit through a hole like this. Are you kidding me? What are they supposed to do? Suck in their fucking, like, what are they supposed to do? Like, suck in their, like, all their fucking, like, their body, and like become a stick and just walk through the hole? I don't know. That show, like, those shows, those CN Real shows were just so stupid. I was so happy when I finally saw them, like, do less and less and less of them, and it just finally just canceled them all together. I was so happy, because it was so dumb. It was just really stupid, in my personal opinion. And then talking about Cartoon Network, you can't talk about Cartoon Network and not talk about Toonami. I really, really, really loved Toonami back in the day, and I still like Toonami today. I just feel like Toonami today is different, of course, from Toonami back in the day. But I don't know. I feel like I'm like a nostalgic person. I loved the Toonami back in the day, because like, Dragon Ball Z was a huge, huge thing on Toonami. It was so big, they had their own, like, they had character bios for each character as a commercial. Like, you'll say, it was like, Gohan, he's like, so much power packed into a tiny body, or some shit like that. You know, they were like, Goku, he is the Saiyan of all Saiyans, or Vegeta, the prince of all Saiyans. You know, he just had that guy. Well, what was it? What, I mean, who was the announcer for that? I can't even remember. Was it Steve Blum? I don't know. Blum? I don't know. I don't know if it was him or not. I don't know. I don't know who the narrator was for that. But I know that Toonami back in the day was just so good. They had like life lessons and stuff like that, and it was just great. It came on every day after home, like after I got home from school. I would sit there and just watch Toonami for like an hour or hour or two, however long it was, and then I'll just watch cartoons for the rest of the night. It was so great. And then like Toonami today, it's nice, but it's definitely a lot more adult rated, obviously, because it's like Adult Swim. But I mean, I enjoy Toonami today. They still do give you like life lessons and stuff every now and again, but I hate it when they canceled Toonami, because that was like a big part of Cartoon Network. And when they canceled Toonami, I was like, what? They're taking away my Toonami? Like, how are they gonna take away my Toonami? And then they replaced it with Magoozy, which I was like, okay, Magoozy, like, what the fuck? Which, another thing, another show, Code Lyoko. Code Lyoko was a great show, by the way. Go watch that shit. That Code Lyoko is awesome. I don't really know about Code Lyoko Evolution. I heard that was like live action. I'm not really all about that live action shit, but Code Lyoko, great show, by the way. But I know that came on I know that came on Magoozy. And I mean, I more or less enjoyed Magoozy, but I enjoyed Toonami way more than that, though. But I don't know. I felt that I feel like Cartoon Network just kind of fell off for a little bit. I mean, they're trying to get them, they're picking themselves back up, and I really do enjoy that. I enjoyed that. I like the fact that they brought back Toonami when they did that April Fool's thing like years ago, and then like everyone was like, bring back Toonami, and then they finally actually brought back Toonami, and I was like, oh shit, this is real. Like, oh my gosh. Like, I like that. And I mean, Cartoon Network today, I mean, of course, there are some shows on Cartoon Network today that I don't like. I don't like Uncle Grandpa. Like, Uncle Grandpa is one of those shows that it makes no sense to me whatsoever. I understand that it's a cartoon, but it's so stupid. Like, how can you be someone's uncle and grandpa? Well, that's like some type of incest shit right there. I don't know. Like, there might be some logical thing behind it, like in terms of like a family tree, but as far as I know, that makes no sense whatsoever. The show Clarence, I don't like that show either. I think it's like garbage. Of course, this is my own personal opinion, by the way, so don't jump down my throat, but I don't know, I just don't like those shows. But the shows I do like, which are the only shows that they show, is I do like Gumball, Amazing World of Gumball. I like Adventure Time, regular show. I like Steven Universe. I like Teen Titans Go. What else do they show? I like Ninjago sometimes. I mean, Ninjago is actually pretty good. I'm not really all about Tenkai Knights or like Beyblade or anything like that. Not the new Beyblades anyway. There's Pokemon. I like Pokemon, obviously. I just don't watch the anime as much. Or I don't watch the English dub anime as much. I don't know, because after I fell off the English dub anime because they're like behind by a little bit. I don't really know what other shows that Cartoon Network shows, but I know that those are really the main shows that I know of on Cartoon Network. And I mean, those are relatively good, but I feel like, for me personally, I feel like the 90s Cartoon Network and like the early 2000s was the best Cartoon Network has ever been, because it's like, I don't know. I don't know how to explain it. I guess it, like, first of all, it's a nostalgic feeling because I grew up with it. So of course I'm going to like be able, I'm going to like it a lot more than the newer stuff. But I just felt that cartoons back in the day were a lot better. They weren't trying to fit adult jokes in every scene or anything like that. It was just strictly hilarious. It was funny. They made you just forget about everything when watching it, you know. And that's kind of how I feel about Cartoon Network overall. If I had any advice for Cartoon Network as a network, I feel like they should do a Throwback Thursday kind of thing, like what Disney Channel does. Like, if you actually look on Disney Channel, like early Thursday morning, you'll see that they play old shows. They play like That's So Raven, Cory in the House. They play Kim Possible, Lilo and Stitch. They'll play I don't know what else they play. Maybe even Steven, I think, and Phil of the Future. I don't know. They play like really old. They play old shit that they used to play on Disney Channel. And I think that Cartoon Network should definitely do some type of Throwback Thursday thing where all day they just show old stuff. Like, they do like the old shit, like the old cartoons, not the new shit, but the really, really old shit, like when they first started. Like, I want them to do that. That would be so awesome if Cartoon Network did that, because then that at least gives... Well, okay, well, I guess they can't do Throwback Thursday because they show new episodes of the current shows on Thursdays. But they could do, like, I don't know. I mean, I honestly can't tell you. Or they could do that all day, and then at 6 o'clock, they'll show all the new shit, you know? Instead of what they do now, because I just feel like Throwback Thursday would be a great thing for Cartoon Network to do. They tried it once before with, like, I don't know what they did. What was it, like the Brock Show or something, where they basically took like the old cartoons and they would mix them all together and you'll just watch them for like an hour. So it'll show like four episodes of like, or they'll show like four different shows, but they'll show one episode of each show. So you'll see like an episode of Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends, and you'll see Ed and Eddie, then you'll see like Dexter's Lab, and you'll see Camp Lazlo, and then they'll end. And I'm like, we only get this for an hour. And then half the time they would try to pull some bullshit and they'll show like a movie or something, or they wouldn't even show it anymore. And I'm just like, where's the Brock Show? Like, I want to watch my old shows. And I noticed that they all been moving to like Boomerang, and I'm sitting here like, okay, so that, I mean, I don't like this at all. I don't like this. So I feel like they should do a Throwback Thursday for sure. I mean, I know that most of the old shows are definitely on Boomerang. I know this, but I still feel like at least they can cater to like the older audience. They can cater to people like me. And I know that Cartoon Network is aimed at kids and everything, but you know, it'll still be kind of cool if they actually aimed it towards everybody, or at least like people like me who are still into cartoons, so that we can still relive the old days and they can still have their new stuff up and running every single day, and then Thursday just do the throwback stuff. I feel like that would be a better thing for Cartoon Network to do, because it's just a better thing to do. And then if it doesn't do well, they can just take it off. But I feel like it'd do well, because then you can expose the younger audience to the older shows, and they can see what we older people actually enjoyed on Cartoon Network back in the day. Now, if they did some Throwback Thursday stuff and they started showing the CN Real stuff, I don't want that. I want, when I say throwback, I mean 90s, early 2000s. That's what I mean when I say throwback. I don't mean throwback in as in show any show that they don't show anymore on Cartoon Network. No. I mean early 2000s, late 90s, early 2000s. That's what I mean. That's what I want. That's really what I want. That's all I want out of Cartoon Network. If they did that, then I'd be a happy person, but they probably won't do that. But if they do, then thank you so much, Cartoon Network. But thank you guys so much for watching this really long rant. It's been like 17 minutes. It's probably gonna be like a little less than 16 once I cut it up and stuff. But thank you guys so much for watching this rant. And if you do watch Cartoon Network, let me know what you guys think of Cartoon Network down in the video or comments below. And if you enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like. And I will see you guys next time. Peace.